Hello, fans. I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Kansas State Wildcats and the Baylor Bears. And here's a look at our Star Watch comparison. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
The matchup at the small forward position should be entertaining. Two good young men who often turn some heads at the wing position.
And it's time for the tip-off.
And they tip off here in the first.
They start the game in a man defense, Dick. The power forward with the ball. Well, Dick, that didn't take very long.
I tell you, they're quick out of the gate, baby.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Controlling the ball. Cross court. He unloads a three off the mark. And we'll get a change of possession. The Wildcats go into their zone motion now. Out on the wing. Puts up the tray. Jumper won't go. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The sideline has been trying to get the team to play more up-tempo. The coaches feel that this is the style that they need to play and will work for them. Definitely something for us to track moving forward, Brad.
That's, of course, Erin Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline. And now, getting set up here in a four-round-one.
I love the four-round-one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
In the lane. Nope. Stokes handles the pass. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Erin Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Down in the low block, trying to work the lane.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the left side. And up. And it goes in. The defense is just getting caught out of position on those backdoor cuts, Dick.
Terrific pass. That's great timing. Caught the defense sleeping. A great backdoor pass.
Can't connect. On the right side. He attempts the trifecta. Perfectly executed. Do you think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
They work the perimeter. For the bucket. Makes it. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
D These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. Off the mark. Count that as a personal foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if we can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
And there's a look at the young freshman.
Hey, Brad, a first-year player starting his college career. Really exciting times in front of this young man.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. That's good. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Coach has been very animated over here on the sidelines. His team is doing a great job of following strategy and playing that up-tempo style. I'm sure he'll continue to encourage them over the course of the game to ensure they don't stray away from what's working.
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team, providing that additional insight. Number 31 takes the pass, tries for two. He hits the shot.
Sort of dumped down inside. Nobody rotated down from up on top.
Takes his jumper, busts the jumper. Trying to pack it inside. The missed shot. Great shot. This guy's really known as more of a power guy.
I tell you, you know, I like the way this kid uses his body, Brad. He's the type of guy you want in your roster. When you want that inside presence, his size and power is an asset.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. He tries the jumper. Busts the J. Number 12 is called for the foul. First team foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots. You know, seniors are a dying breed in college basketball these days. If you're a coach that's lucky enough to have a couple, it can definitely help you sleep at night knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful.
Second shot is no good.
Pressure that basketball.
On the dribble, gives it up. He goes up with it. They get it to go. Sneed receives the pass. Takes the jumper. Missed it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Off the mark. He pulls up with a jumper. Jumper won't go. On the left side. Perimeter. puts it on the floor and up and under.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Number 12 is whistled for the foul. Second personal foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Opportunity now for an easy one. He misses the first shot. Both shots no good. On the outside. For two. He shows the sweet touch. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. He gets it to go. Goes up for two. Did the guy in the stands call for it? On the right side. They'll work it around the arc. He tries to knock down the three. Can't connect.
There it is, Jam City.
Wow, what a finish on that back cut.
Hey, when you can mix teamwork and execution, you get plays like that, Mr. Nesler.
Out on the wing. Gave it up. He shoots from the corner. Number 25 hits the three. Freeman receives the ball. Bad decision there by the freshman. On the left side. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using clock shot. Usually creates momentum and opportunities.
The crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Off the glass and no good. The point guard with the ball. Goes up. Missed the jumper. Number zero gets the pass. Number zero. His inferior play is really affecting his composure now.
Emotionally, he needs some inspiration. Shooter spotting up on a three.
Goes up with it. Knocked it down. Now they work it around the perimeter. He goes for three, nails the J.
He's just not giving the effort on defense.
He's not putting up a good fight at all. Down in the low block, trying to work the lane. Nope. Pushes it up. With a deep shot from outside. The missed shot. working around the perimeter. He bombs from outside. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nesler. Horrible shot selection.
Both teams looking to get things going here. He unloads. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one.
Working it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Sinks it. To get it to the inside with the J and come up short. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Bears have not done a good job of playing an up-tempo style. As you can tell, the coaching staff has been pretty animated over here on the sidelines. They are begging their players to push the ball and look to attack offensively. After all, that's their team style of play. Brad?
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent. All of you know that with an additional insight there. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock.
Up and inside.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I'll tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Cross court. Switch up. 10 on the shot clock. He looks for three, nails the jumper. Now looking for the ball screen, Dick.
Hey, a two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporated into their scheme because it works.
And score it. There's a slam. He tries the three ball. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. And we've got a change in possession here. And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
I tell you, as a coach, Brad, it's always nice to have a player surprisingly step up and perform better than expected. We'll have to keep a close eye on him moving forward. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Bust the jumper. Moving it around the perimeter. From right at the circle. Can't get the shot to go. Nice shot. Looking for a good shot. For two, he nails the bucket. The power forward takes the feed. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Greens it. We're at the 5 minute mark. He hammers it
didn't see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
Trying to pack it inside.
Excellent jump shot right there.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Bad decision there by the freshman. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He wants a three. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
We're at the four-minute mark. He can't beat the trap.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
Look at that spacing.
He launches a three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Out on the wing. Goes up for two. Sinks the shot. The outside. Tries for two. Got it. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
That's a bang bang play, Brad. That's a great cut and an even better pass. Turnover committed by the senior.
On the left side. Fade away. He misses the fade away. We're at the 3 minute mark. On the left side. He shoots the jumper. Can't connect and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They work the perimeter. For two. Drains the shot. Attempts the jump shot. Off the mark. Looking for a good shot. From the corner. Nope. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Puts up the jumper, knocks it down. Cross court. He pulls the trigger, goes. Gave it up for the bucket. It sticks. One minute left on the game clock. Freeman receives the pass. Missed the jumper. Dribble, gives it up, unloads, missed it. The point guard handles the feed, goes up for two. Oh, yes. Good find on that back cut, Mr. Vitale.
Great delivery on that back cut. He just hit him at the right time.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He shoots from outside. The missed shot. Gave it up. He tries the three.
Off the mark.
At the half, the Bears are behind by 7. Game summary.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who's been doing what.
Looks like a full court man-to-man press, Mr. Vitale. Tries for 2. He can't get the hoop to fall. Stokes receives the ball.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the 3-point line.
They work it around the perimeter. With a jumper. Jumper won't go. He throws it up from downtown. Nails the J. For 2. Can't get it to go. On the dribble, gives it up. Unloads a 3. Nails the jumper. On the outside. From 3-point territory. That's an ill-advised shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
The small forward with the ball. He puts up the J. He's taken too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's busted his team their rhythm.
Loose ball, kept in. Knocked it down. Gave it up. He attempts the 3. And score it. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Looks in a 3. They got it. On the dribble, gives it up. Ball stripped. On the left side.
Silly mistake.
The Wildcats looking to attack now in transition. They'll work it around the arc. For the bucket. He hits it. With the runner, tickles a twine. Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from downtown. They get it to go. They work it around the perimeter. The freshman has a brain cramp there and commits a turnover. See that? Working it around the perimeter. From left of the circle. Gets the J to fall. The Bears like to play that up-tempo style, Dick. What allows teams like them to play that style?
They sure are. They like to recruit athletes. Namely guys who can get out and run, fill the lanes, and pressure opponents. Dump it inside!
Here comes the ball screen. Gave it up. Goes up with a shot and come up short. Pushes it up. He shoots. Scorches the net with a J. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He puts up the three ball.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Missed it. Number 31 receives the ball. Goes up for two. Gets it to go. Up the J. Jumper won't go. Freeman handles the pass. Throws it up. And it's heading out of bounds. No! Great save. Change of possession. It's been a great team effort for these guys tonight, Dick.
I tell you, if you're on the floor, that means your coach trusts you and believes you can play a role out there. Hey, we've seen some great plays from a number of different players so far, and that always makes things difficult for an opponent.
The Wildcats are going into their zone motion offense now. Down inside. Tries for two. Buried it. On the dribble, gives it up. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility, who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Now, looking to attack. Moving it around the perimeter. From the corner, nails the jumper.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
The small forward takes the pass. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
Gave it up. A little two-man action. For two. He can't get the bucket to fall. There's the rejection. Can't connect. Tries one from three-point land. The missed shot. Tries for two. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up.
They keep forcing him to set up in a half court
with a tremendous block. On the right side. Looking for a good shot. Goes up with it. Knocked it down.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented blocks out there.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up. They got it. With the J. Nope. On the dribble, gives it up. Lobs it. There's a double team waiting there. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
Great job of using the bounce to get to the rim. Not too many defenses that can stop that move.
Out on the wing. Takes a three, nails the J.
Look at that spacing.
Puts up the J. If it's going down, you can't touch it. Let's take a second look at this three. Side. He takes the shot. Can't get the shot to drop. They work the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner for the deuce.
What a terrific play, though, to tip that ball back. The awareness, the basketball IQ.
He tries the jumper. Scores it.
Charge.
Well, that one's going the other way. Now let's check back in now on our Star Watch player. On the right side. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the deep corner. Bust the jumper. Goes up for two. He drains the bucket. The Bears have no choice but to continue their up-tempo style of play and try to eat into this deficit, Dick.
Although the clock is not on their side, they still have a chance. They like to play their up-tempo style, so getting quick baskets is definitely achievable.
Cats are going to try to hold on to the lead here, but should probably do so by playing in the half court as opposed to that up-tempo style, Dick.
I think they'll look to settle down. They should be running longer offensive sets, which allow for the ball to move and the clock to wind down. I'll be surprised if there are any early shots.
And a momentary look from three-point land. He unloads a three. They get it to go. Go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
The small forward receives the pass. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. I thought good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk, lift their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
They work it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray, missed the jumper. On the left side. On the outside. He attempts the trifecta. He misses the jumper. The small forward receives the pass. We're at the 6-minute mark. Steals the ball. Stokes handles the pass. He tries to knock down the three. No good. Gave it up.
Turnover by the freshman.
Pushes it up. He draws a foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, this is now one of the better free throw shooting teams in college basketball, that's for sure.
You have to be able to shoot free throws no matter where or how much you play.
Drained
it. Nothing but nylon. MBN.
They've got him right where they want him, Richard. On the right side.
Double team now. Bad angle.
Stolen away. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Strip, quick hand. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. On the dribble, gives it up. The freshman commits a turnover. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Tries for two. That was nice. They'll work it around the arc. Buries it home. He goes up with it. Missed it. Bad decision there by the freshman. On the left side. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Now they work it around the perimeter. He goes for three. Bust the J. The Bears like to play that up-tempo style, Dick. What allows teams like them to play that style?
One thing which stands out in my mind is the type of defense they play. Often up-tempo teams will press, trap, and disrupt the offense at every chance they get.
On the right side. Puts it up. Jumper won't go. They work it around the perimeter. For two, he nails the shot. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
That's a great take, Brad. That puts pressure on the defense when you go to the hoop like that.
For the bucket, scorches the net. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Gave it up. He pulls up with a jumper. Off the mark. The small forward takes the pass. Goes up for two. He gets the shot to fall. On the left side. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Out on the wing. He shoots from the corner. And he missed. Working it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. Knocks it down. 2 minutes left on the game clock.
Up and inside.
Shoots from outside. Nope. Now looking to attack. From three-point land. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots killed chemistry, Brad.
Here's the three ball. Scorches the net with a J. On the left side. For two. He buries it. We're at the 1 minute mark. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. For the bucket. Knocks it down. Pushes it up.
Nice hop.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. There's the trap. They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy, too much mustard there.
Pushes it up. Goes up for two. You betcha. Great strength on that drive.
That's a great job, Brad. Using his athleticism to get to the hoop and convert.
Johnson receives the ball. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turan fadeaway, down low, but kicked out. And now let's take a look at our players of the game.
A real nice performance by both young guys. Some special, special players.
Baylor loses in a well-fought match.
I don't think anyone expected him to pull out a win tonight.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.